Welcome into Charger Arena for Skyridge basketball on the Rewind Sports Network on KSLSports.com. Dusty Lister with you. So glad to have you along with us tonight. The Skyridge Falcons continue Region 4 play as they come to Draper to take on the Corner Canyon Chargers, the number one team in 6A basketball. For Coach Jeff Gardner and his Falcons, 0-2 start in Region 4 play. A heartbreaking game Tuesday night against Lone Peak. And then there's not much time, as you know, in Region 4 in almost every sport. No time to lick your wounds. You got to turn right back around and come up to Draper to take on Corner Canyon, a team that is playing really, really well. And for Coach Gardner, really big tonight, Mason Hunter. Mason has got to get involved early on in the season, or early on in this game. 15 points per game throughout the early part of the season. He played well against Lone Peak. I know it's not his game to push up. He's got to be that guy. J.J. Jory or somebody else who's going to step up and be that guy to help give some support scoring. When you take a look at Corner Canyon, Coach Dan Lunt and the Chargers, 13-2 on the season. Those two losses are to out-of-state teams. This is a spectacular team. One of the best players in the state, Max Toombs, who scored 46 points earlier in the year against a team from Maryland. And, of course, Brody Kozlowski, the four-star recruit, who's going to be jumping it up against Cy Hansen. And we are underway from Corner Canyon High School. Start first with Corner Canyon. This is Jackson Roberts, an outstanding point guard, senior, up top to Farrow. Farrow to Kozlowski, Brody. Short, he got the bounce. So a three-pointer for Brody Kozlowski, and it's 3-0. We deemed him last year in the state tournament. Big shot, Brody. Of course, Corner Canyon got to the state championship game. Lost to American Fork. Backdoor cut, Mason Hunter lays it in. Love his game. It'll be so much fun to watch him more closely. As every region game for Skyridge will be right here on KSLSports.com. Farrell, this is Roberts from the corner. A little too strong. That ball loose. And we're going to have a loose ball foul on J.J. Jory. It'll be Corner Canyon basketball on the baseline. Mentioned once again, as always, my crew, most times not, the always adequate AAA, Austin Bigelow and Kinsey Valentine running the scoreboard. Intern Preston has been retired, or been put on leave of absence. Toombs can't get that, and it's Jackson Roberts with the tip in. So down the floor, Larson hands off to Jory. J.J. back to Mason Hunter. Hunter sends to the corner. Josh Davis thought about three and held on. 20 on the shot clock. Down to 15. Hansen with 9. Sai sends out. Davis going to get that off. Neither could Jory. Nice closeout by Farrow. 3 seconds on the shot. Jory's got to shoot. Pulls. Nearly got the desperation heave to drop. Now on the push, Callen Lewis, straight away, Kozlowski, his second three of the first quarter. Timeout on the floor, 8-2 start for Corner Canyon. You're watching Skyridge basketball on the Rewind Sports Network. 8-2 start, Corner Canyon, 2 threes from Brody Kozlowski. And then Jackson Roberts had that tip in. But we'll see Skyridge bounce back. A little full court press here from Corner Canyon. It is Mason able to break it, hands off to Larson. Tate near side to JJ, back to Davis. High post to Cy Hansen, back out to Larson for three. Was online but just missed. Quickly on the push with Kozlowski. Farrell to Toombs. Callen Lewis sends out the ball in the corner to Farrell. Whoa. Lewis on the drive, sends back out to Kozlowski. He'll reset the offense. Shot clock down to 13 seconds. Three on the way, short from Farrell. Robertson get called on the loose ball foul on the rebound. It'll be the first team foul of the first half here for Corner Canyon. Of course, this is a rematch of the football state championship football game. Skyridge getting their first win of Corner Canyon for a long time. Cy Hansen tried to cycle that through. Roberts with a save to Farrow. What a play. Here comes Callan Lewis. Leaves it for Toombs. Can't get the three to go to rebound to Cy Hansen. Cookie down the floor with Tate Larson. Mason Hunter. Oh, I love the idea there for Mason. Just couldn't get it around the two defenders. We'll stay here with the Falcons. And Ethan Gagan comes on along with Cannon Jensen. 22 seconds on the shot clock. Cannon Jensen, 4-3. What a way to come off the bench and make an impact. Who says you need to get in rhythm? Show up in rhythm. Skip over to Callan Lewis. Misses the answer three. Toombs with the board. Try to save it in. Picked up by Larson. Tate on the push. Give it up to Mason Hunter. Transition three. Didn't get the bounce. And Kozlowski will clear the board. Four and a half left in the opening frame. Farrell goes into Kozlowski. Brody draws the foul on Gagan. Kozlowski, fall away, yes. 8 points in the quarter for Brody Kozlowski. 24-7 as him as a four-star recruit. Mama Kozlowski straight away from us here. There's Mason Hunter. Sends that over to Gagan, gets it back. 15 on the shot. Jensen to Larson. Tate along the baseline, try to poke that through, but taken away by Farrow. Oh, nearly backcourt, but heads up play. Euro, no, followed by Lewis. There's a lot of height and length on this Corner Canyon squad, and Callan Lewis, one of those guys, is Gagan, throws that one away. Tough to make passes from the baseline. Is Toombs to Kozlowski. And he'll hand off to Jackson Roberts and reset the offense here for Coach Dan Lunt. Roberts. Gonna get the blocking foul on Tate Larson. That'll be the fourth team foul on Skyridge. And coming into the game is Tate Van Komen. As Cannon Jensen will come off the floor. Inbound into Lewis, open for three, no. Rebound to Roberts. Jackson, nice pass inside to Kozlowski, who finishes through the contact. And a 10-point first quarter for Brody Kozlowski. Timeout. Skyridge. We'll be right back. You're watching Skyridge Basketball on KSLSports.com. And welcome back into Charge Arena. As always, KSL Sports Rewind presented by Heidemann & Associates. Go to utah.law to find the law office nearest to you. You get a free consultation when you let them know the Rewind sent you. Again, that's Heidemann & Associates at utah.law. 9-point advantage for Corner Canyon as Josh Davis gets out on the baseline. A little fall away, no. Good contest there from Kozlowski. Toombs trying to get some space from Hunter, goes under him. No, and the rebound to Van Komen. Tate had that big three last week, or on Tuesday night. Man, that was not last week, that was Tuesday against Lone Peak. A corner three that touched every part of the rim as we're outside of Hunter. Mason hand back to Gagan. Clumsy, but not a travel. It's Van Komen back to Larson, high post to Davis. Nine on the shot clock. Skyridge gonna get a shot up. Hunter contested three wide to the right, and it was deflected. So a block to Toombs, and we'll stay here with Skyridge. Cy Hansen and J.J. Jory come back on for Coach Gardner. 5 seconds on the shot clock here for Skyridge. Into Gagan, back over to Larson for three. No. Lewis with the board now on the push of Roberts. They'll reset here for Coach Lunt. Here's Brody. Back to Toombs. Max got that extra step. We've been called charge or travel. They're going to go charge here on Max Toombs. I was surprised he didn't try to bargain with him. Say, hey, just give me the travel. So first foul on Max. His hand back, J.J. Jory. Had a hot shooting hand on Tuesday. Hasn't been able to get his first two shots to drop tonight. So back down the floor is Brody Kozlowski. He's got 10 points in the quarter. Brody sent to the corner. Three on the way, no, from Nybauer. Borden on the run with Van Komen. Cy Hansen, yet to assert himself in the offense. Cy sent to the corner, Van Komen for three. No, and the board to Cy Hansen. Fresh shot clock here for the Falcons. Goes back up through the contact, can't get it to go. On the run, Roberts. Looking for Nybauer. They'll say out of bounds off Nybauer. So back to Skyridge, 43 seconds left. Cy Hansen sends back out J.J. Jory. About an 8 second difference between game and shot. Fiennes. He's open for three. There you go. Davis Fiennes, the freshman. He's a freshman. Knocking down a much needed bucket there for Skyridge. 10 seconds left in the quarter. Roberts sends up top. Poked away by Gagan. 5 seconds. Three. Got a chase down by Nybauer. And he's got the foul. So going to line, Ethan Gagan. The defense led to the opportunity. And now Gagan with a couple of free throws with 1.7 left in the opening frame. So knocks down the first. Goes 1-2, got his own board and the bucket as the horn sounds. A tough first quarter, but a good last minute. A three from the freshman, Davis Fiennes. Good defense from Gagan. Splits the pair on the free throws, but gets his board and bucket. And at the end of one, it's Corner Canyon 14, Skyridge 11. You're watching Falcon basketball on KSL Sports Rewind. Start of the second quarter, Dusty Litster with you. Again, a great close of the quarter for the Skyridge Falcons. It was a tough quarter. It was 14-5. And then Davis Fiennes hit a three. Oh, he had to inbound go off his knee. He was going to set up a chance to shoot. They hit a three and tie the game, but missed opportunity there for Skyridge. I almost got to do the basketball equivalent of the tie or Tom Brady end of the half scenario, but couldn't quite make it happen. Callum Lewis open for three. Can't get it. Rebound off of Kozlowski. So get the defensive stop and again a chance to get within one or take the lead here in the beginning part of the second quarter. back down the floor with the Falcons.
Oh,
Fiennes goes to the floor. Here's Davis, hands back to Jory. JJ sends out Fiennes, goes base, float it off the side of the board, but board there for Hansen. Send out JJ Jory, 4-3. There's a Celtic legend who is the great comp for JJ Jory. I love that kid. As Toombs gets his first point of the night. I'll just say, he's the Brian Scalabrine of Utah High School basketball. He walks on in the gym. He had the student section giving him nonsense. But dude can flat out shoot. He does all the little things that helps his team. Drop that into Hansen. Double team was there. Out to Hunter and Mason with his second bucket. And we're tied at 16. Up top of Toombs. Old school fans would have wanted a whistle on that one. But here comes Roberts, and he's fouled on the take. This can go on Fiennes. It'll be number one on Davis. And that's a comp that's been burning in my pocket ever since the second quarter on Tuesday. Awesome. Triple A knows. Always dependable and always adequate. There's a nice find inside on the inbound there for Farrell. Farrell was that guy for me last year. I remember seeing him at the Holiday Hoop Fest. And man, you don't have to run plays for Farrell. He finds the way for the ball to get in his hands to make an impact. Oh, Hunter on the take and the make. Mason Hunter, 6 points and a half. This Farrell goes over to Kozlowski. Brody send into the corner to Farrell. Back up top to Brody, over to Toombs. Oh, what a take there, Max Toombs. His family originally from Calgary, well, not from Calgary, but from Alberta. His mother, I was told, is the best athlete in the family. From an old friend of both of ours. And there's a steal to Roberts. Jackson got away from Hunter and lays it in. So the Chargers increase their lead to 4. Mason Hunter terminates, falls away, and hits. Oh, that was pretty. Talk about Mason Hunter. He's a blend of Nick Holland and Duncan Reed. Love his game. Over to Kozlowski, Brody. Long on the triple, and the rebound to Jory. Here's Jory, hands back to, Davis. That was a dangerous pass. Cy Hansen got the contact. Didn't get the hoop in the arm. They got the hoop. Tied back up at 22. Roberts on the angle to Farrell. Back up top to Brody Kozlowski. In the corner, Toombs. Pump the three, pull the three, no. Rebound to Hansen. Larson doesn't take the shot there to Hunter. Now into the corner. Mason. Back up top to Larson. Now outside to Davis. JJ. Cross court to Hunter. 18 on the shot clock. Larson gets it to Hansen. 8 on the shot. Tate Larson on the push. No. And then the rebound to Kozlowski. Quick on the push, here comes Farrell. Max Toombs. Oh, good hands by Hansen. Ball still loose. Jump ball will keep it here with Corner Canyon. Good defense. Thought it was great hands there by Hansen. He didn't get his hand in there without drawing the foul. There's a little bound along the baseline. They'll lob in to Kozlowski. Brody goes at Gagan. Misses wildly on that one. Callum Lewis there for the board and put back. They're letting them play around the rim. Oh, Gagan on the take and make. Ethan Gagan. He's got five. Kozlowski just got that into Callen Lewis. Nice job moving that the basketball. And Callen Lewis lays it in. Mason Hunter. Oh, Cannon Jensen just got that back from Davis on the take, and it's Cannon Jensen drawing the foul. They put Cannon at the line for two. And that foul goes to Max Toombs, number two on Max. Well, Coach Lent trusts him. So 2:49 left. I think they're gonna leave Max in here. And the first free throw, no good for Cannon. Jensen with 3 points and a half. Goes 0 for 2 with the strike. So missed chance there. As Roberts misses on the three and a rebound to Gagan. Tate Larson hands back to Hunter. Out top to Josh Davis. Josh, jab step at Kozlowski. Series of moves in the key. Has to put up the shot and got it to go. And he gives it, hey, he wanted an and one. A little Rip Hamilton face mask is going to bother Josh Davis as Max Toombs is going to draw a, you see, a two-shot foul. Foul on Gagan. They're going to call it a two. I thought he was. Yeah. So Max is the first. And Max gets them both. 4 points for Max Toombs. There's Tate Larson. And it's back to Van Coleman. Top to Gagan. Hunter short on the three, and it's Lewis with the board. Here comes Toombs. Kind of a take foul there, interesting from Larson. That'll be the sixth team foul on the Falcons. Number two on Tate. This is a surprise how aggressive he was on that. Outside with Kozlowski, hands off the Toombs. Max off the screen. Brody sends out to Farrow. Back rims the triple. Loose ball tracked down by Roberts. Back to Max Toombs. The three won't go. Rebound to Cy Hansen. Oh, and then a defensive foul here on Corner Canyon. It'll be just the fifth team foul on the Chargers. Minute 20 to go. We'll go minute 19. Here comes J.J. Jory. Good hands here by Roberts. And Larson turns it over. And no, out of bounds or foul first? Foul first on Tate Larson will be number three as Davis Fine's going to come in this game. It'll be 1-1 free throws for Max Toombs. Davis Fine's And hits the front end of 1-1. Hey, always good to see the state record holder for yards per carry. State record holder, yards per carry, Sean Hagen. Also the father of the fastest man in the state of Utah's history. Good to see him. So 4-point lead here for the Chargers. As Davis Fiennes will hand off to Mason Hunter. High post to Hanson, back to Mason. 23 on the shot. Hunter, they're poked away. Fiennes had to go off of him. And we'll go back to Corner Canyon. Jackson Roberts just got his fingertips on that ball, and Davis Fiennes went after it and couldn't pull his hands back. So Tate Van Coma will come back on for J.J. Jory. 15-second difference between game clock and shot clock in the final 45 seconds of the first half. Brody Kozlowski hands off to Roberts, now Toombs. A little staggered screen. Max goes at Hanson, pull up. And it crawls off, rebound loose, saved in by Hunter, and taken by Gagan. Shot clock turned off here for the Falcons. The young freshman wanted to push it, and Coach Gardner just, hey, you got to teach the young 14-year-old. He might be 15 now. 10 on the game clock. Mason Hunter, good. That's a good foul there from Max Toombs. Well, I take that back. That's number three on Max Toombs. Situationally, normally, he says good, but that's number three on Max. That is the sixth team foul on the Chargers. 8.6 left. Seven seconds. Trying to get that ball to Jory. Couldn't get it there. Calvin Lewis. Oh, then they're still there to Tate Larson. But we'll go back to Corner Canyon. 1.2 left in the half. Farrell lobs it to Kozlowski, couldn't get his hands on it. And that'll do it for the first half. As we go to the locker rooms, it's Corner Canyon 30, Skyridge 26. You're watching Skyridge Basketball on KSL Sports Rewind on kslsports.com. And welcome back to Charge Arena, Dusty Litster, Austin Bigelow, and Kenzie Valentin with you. Love the fight we saw from Skyridge in the first half. And it's gonna have to continue in the second half. They got some foul trouble in some spots. But Corner Canyon has more foul trouble in bigger spots. Max Toombs starting this half with three fouls. And he's the leading scorer on the season for Corner Canyon. As Mason Hunter goes at Toombs. Toombs had to give up on that play. And then see who this foul goes to. And it goes to Max Toombs. That is number four on Max, so you're not going to have Max Toombs until, well, we'll see when Coach Dan Lunt decides to go back to Max. But Max has to stay on for the first free throw. So to the line goes Mason Hunter, where Skyridge has got to make a dent. Had some free throw troubles in the first half and may have spoke it into existence there. Misses the first. And got the second. So back down the floor in the first possession here for Corner Canyon. Jackson Roberts. The thing about this Corner Canyon team, it is deep. And there's Brody Kozlowski. He's the highest rated recruit on this team. He's also a junior. He'll come back next year. And you got an offensive foul on the screen on Jackson Roberts. That is number two on Jackson. So opportunities are right in front of this Skyridge team. And they find some consistent form of offense here. That's where we need Mason to continue to be himself. And then guys like J.J. Jory and others to chip in with some big shots. Larson to Jory, hands off to Josh Davis, high post to Hansen. Sy goes back out to Larson, Tate for three, no, and the rebound taken away by Kozlowski. On the run with Neibauer. Brody on the trail. Oh, reverse out. Kozlowski along the baseline, fits that in to Farrell, goes too strong, but got his own board. Little stat stuffer there for Farrell. And Taylor, well, the side of the scores aren't working for Corner Canyon. That's 4 points for him, as that three won't go for Josh Davis, and the board cleared by Kozlowski. Jackson Roberts. Sends over to Callen Lewis. Now Neibauer. Isaac goes inside to Kozlowski. Brody trying to find an angle. Skip to Roberts, straight away with Farrow. Taylor had that ball poked away, but got to Neibauer, and Isaac Neibauer lays it up and in. And a 7-point lead for Corner Canyon. Largest lead was 15-6. Actually, 15-5. 14-5. As Mason Hunter climbs the ladder for that one. Mason on the drive and make. So they need more of, get him isolated on defender. Mason Hunter can make it work. 5-point ball game. Roberts sends out to Farrell, back inside to Neibauer. And they'll reset. 20 on the shot clock. Kozlowski's third three of the night. I got him unofficially 13 points for Brody Kozlowski at 10 in the first quarter. Did not score in the second. And knocks down the three there. Josh Davis gives it up to Hansen. Sy. End of the corner. Davis pumped the three. Terminates. Fall away. Good defense by Farrow. Here comes Kozlowski. Brody again for three. And it crawls off the board to Mason Hunter. And he was going for all the momentum right there. Was Kozlowski. Is Hunter going to get the foul before the block to Neibauer? That should be on the shot. That was in his habitual shooting motion. And it will be two free throws as Isaac Neibauer picks up the foul. Number two on Neibauer. Second team foul of the second half. Or pardon me, third team foul. Set the line, Mason Hunter. As he knocks down his 12th point of the night. Yeah, Mason got them both. So 12 points in the ball game for Mason Hunter. And a 6-point lead for Corner Canyon. Kozlowski skips through, nice ball movement inside, and a bucket to Isaac Neibauer. ...39-31, Jory short on the three, rebound taken by Farrow. Skip through to Lewis for three. Timeout, Coach Gardner. 3:42 left in the third, and Corner Canyon, without Max Toombs, have built their largest lead of the night. 42-31, you're watching Falcon basketball on the Rewind Sports Network. 3:42, I'm gonna call it 3:41 left in the third quarter. Dusty Litster, Austin Bigelow, and Kenzie Valentin here at Charger Arena. Skyridge basketball on KSL Sports Rewind. Well, the Falcons in the largest deficit of the night. And Corner Canyon doing it really without Max Toombs, as he has not scored a lot, but he's been in foul trouble. He's got four personal fouls, leading scorer on the season for Corner Canyon. But they're being pushed and bolstered by Brody Kozlowski. Mason Hunter got stuck in the air. And then Gagan cannot track that down, so a turnover. The ball will go back to Corner Canyon. In the corner to Lewis, drop it into Kozlowski. Brody goes up strong, give him two free throws. As the foul's going to go to J.J. Jory, who came on the backside there. It'll be Brody Kozlowski going to the free throw line for two. Before Brody with unofficially 13 points. 14. And now 15 points. Where can the Falcons turn as they turn that one over? Trying to find Jory along the baseline. Quickly on the push from Corner Canyon. Nybauer. Back up top to Jackson Roberts. Roberts in the lane gets the foul on Larson, and that's going to be number four on Tate Larson. So that's going to bring Davis Fiennes off the bench. And to the line goes Jackson Roberts. Should say this, the most left-handed shooters you're going to probably see in any game this year. As these two meet up again in the state tournament. Between Roberts and Hunter. Cy Hansen. And Roberts got them both. 15-point lead for Corner Canyon. The Skyridge have a run in them. High post to Hansen. Poked away by Farrow. Tracked down. No, didn't touch it. So we'll stay with the Falcons. 18 seconds on the shot clock. 2:20 left in the quarter. Intern Preston never had the clock as right as Kinsey Valentin does. That is for certain. All right, clock is unofficial. It's really close to official when Kinsey's running it. Intern Preston would fall asleep at the wheel a lot. On the drive, Gagan, no. And the board to Corner Canyon. And if you're yelling at your screen for a goaltending, it's not a goaltend in high school. As Jackson Roberts goes right to the rim and scores. Utah, or pardon me, not even just Utah high school basketball. Nash NFHS rules, you can attempt to block and slap the backboard. As J.J. Jory misses on the three and a rebound to Hansen. We're going to have a loose ball foul on the rebound. The foul on Nybauer. That is number three on Isaac. Skyridge been stuck on 31 for a while here. Up top, Mason Hunter. On the drive, Davis Fiennes. Kozlowski sends it back. Like an old man, send back soup but the deli. Sends that one away. Fiennes drawing the foul on Jackson Roberts. That'll be number three on Roberts. He bodied him on his way. On his drive, he took away that space. Quickly into Hunter. Mason. Oh, nice drop off there to Cy Hansen, blocked from behind by Nybauer. Hansen stuck with it. And gets the bucket, ends the drought here for the Falcons. Quickly the other way. Hanging on a pivot there is Chandler. Roberts stepped through, misses, and the rebound to Hunter. Cannon Jensen, oh, nice wraparound to Cy Hansen. Back-to-back buckets for Hansen, just like the first quarter. Here comes a little spurt from the Falcons as Roberts fouled on the drive. We'll see if this goes to Hansen or to Fiennes. And it goes to Davis. So reset the shot clock. 44 seconds left here in the quarter. Kozlowski over to Lewis. Callen goes into Brody. Trap comes. Oh, and Gagan for the reach. And that'll be the fourth team foul on the Falcons. Number three on Gagan. Good to see Justin Enna, the new linebacker coach at BYU, walk in the building. Just missed his sweet wife who just left. So 28 seconds left in the half. Neibauer back over. It's Tate Bowman. Seven seconds on the shot clock. 5 seconds. Callen Lewis open for three, and he got it. His second three of the quarter at the horn. Davis Fiennes. And at the end of three, it is Corner Canyon with their largest lead of the night, 51-35. You're watching Skyridge Basketball on KSL Sports Rewind on KSLSports.com. We'll be back with the fourth quarter. Start of the fourth quarter. Dusty Litster with you. 16-point advantage when Max Toombs went out with foul trouble. Picked up his fourth foul early in the third quarter. Thought that'd be an advantage for Skyridge, and just could not find the offense as Corner Canyon seemed to just really focus in. And Callen Lewis hit a couple of threes. Kozlowski got going a little bit more, and Corner Canyon leading by 16. Chandler in the corner, going to drop it into Kozlowski. Brody sends out Callen Lewis. Misses on the three. Neibauer with the board and goes back up. A little too strong. Cy Hansen tracks that down. Hands off to Fiennes. Fiennes to the corner to Hunter. Now Van Komen. Tate. It's a tough pass into Cy Hansen, who got his first points of the night to close out the third. Kohler, first action we've seen of him tonight. Up top, Van Komen. Try to send that in. Good hands. And a turnover. Three from Kozlowski, back rimmed. Rebound out to Lewis. Callen fires that one back in, a little too tall for Chandler. Now on the run, Fiennes. Oh, that pretty pass. Hansen couldn't handle it. Goes off the corner. Canyon will stay here. That really was a pretty pass. Of course, Jordan Kohler, the younger brother of Jackson Kohler, who got his first double-double of his college career last night for Sparty. I know Jackson's watching. He's going to text him. Didn't want to bug him. But congratulations, Jackson. A great start to his college career. Three from Fiennes is good. Young freshman Davis Fiennes. 6 points on the night. And out of play more with foul trouble to Tate Larson. As Farrow gets that into Kozlowski. Was at Van Komen. Left it short. And the rebound in the hands of Kohler. On the push now, Mason Hunter. Should have mentioned the Max Toombs back in the game for corner. As all nice pass and little maverick move from Cy Hansen. Just hit the brakes and he'll fly right by. Lays that up and in. Callen Lewis misses on the three but picks up the foul. Or draws the foul and he'll go to the line for three free throws. So got a little bit of momentum here for Skyridge and fouling on a three. And so Callen at the line.
Knocks down the first. First memory of Calvin Lewis this year was at the Holiday Hoop Fest playing against Beaumont United. Those guys didn't realize that Calvin Lewis was a little bigger than they thought. Took a kid baseline and threw it down on him. Kind of got things going. That was a night that Corner Cannon loved to have back on their resume. They had played so well the night before. And then day two, Beaumont United at Wesley Yates III. A man going to go to Washington, number 13 recruit in the country. He got going in the second half, and it was just a tough night for Corner Canyon. But they've been on a roll since. 13-point game. Oh, Davis was already cutting, and then picked up by Roberts. Jackson Roberts with the flush! He had two big dunks against American Fork last week. Gets that one there. Kohler trying to step through, lost the handle. Roberts on the push. Jackson leaves it for Lewis, and he got the bucket. Mason Hunter luckily did not give up the plus one, but a nice strong take and finish. As this game was down 11, now up to 17. Van Coleman gives it up to Hunter. Mason over to Davis Fiennes. Another three for the young freshman. Basketball is a marathon of a season. You're going to find guys. And you get a night like this tonight from Davis Fiennes is something you can build on for Coach Gardner. Sends out to Toombs. Max gives it up to Lewis on the baseline. And Callum Lewis. I talked about that drive against Beaumont United. That was almost exactly it, a carbon copy of it. Timmer finished in a dunk. This one with a strong hoop and a arm. Takes the bump and bucket, and he'll go to the line. Five minutes left in the fourth quarter, and Davis, Josh Davis is going to come back on along with J.J. Jory. As Calvin Lewis misses the plus one. The rebound tracked down by Lewis. Skips to Roberts. Jackson goes at Hunter. And the foul there to Mason Hunter. Look, I know it's the Skyridge stream. And I know we have a lot of corner fans watching, and I'm called the corner homer. That was a charge. But I don't go after officials anymore. I actually got a call from an official the other day thanking me for clarifying the goaltending rule in the state. But that was tough. I thought Jackson Roberts lowered the shoulder, put down the boom on that one. But block charge is the toughest one to call. Knocks down the front end. And one-on-one, that's the seventh team foul on the Falcons. And he gets them both. So Mason Hunter on the take. A little wild. Thought he'd get a whistle. Didn't. Here comes Max Toombs. Crossover. Misses on the three. And rebound taken by Gagan. Josh Davis sends out to Gagan, comes off the screen. Davis off the bump and bucket. Count it for the two-sport athlete. So Davis will go to the line looking for the three-point play. Is that his number four on Jackson Roberts? I haven't seen if Jackson's older brother here. We were in the worst math class in all the world. At BYU together. It's so bad, I can't remember what numbers come at the end of it. I think it was like math 1030 or something like that. Terrible, terrible, terrible class. 15-point game with 4:13 on a rolling clock. Max Toombs drops that in to Kozlowski, sends out to Lewis. Calvin Lewis again on the take and the make. Avoids the Josh Davis, and no plus one as he comes right back down the floor. Davis sends out to Larson. Kenan Jensen, Larson, now Gagan. Gagan on the drive, lost the handle, turns it over. Of course, the state tournament just over a month away. We will be, remember, home sites the first two rounds. And then quarterfinals through championships up at the Event Center. And Corner Canyon, of course, their lone state championship in basketball came on that floor. And they would love to raise another banner. Nice pass to Davis. Plus one for Davis. His second plus one of the fourth quarter. And he'll go back to the free throw line. Number one on Callan Lewis. As Tate Van Komen will come on for Tate Larson. Free throw short. And a rebound tracked down by Jackson Roberts. Kozlowski sends out Taylor Farrow, 4-3. So imagine you not to run the offense for him. That kid will find the ball. The ball will end up in his hands one way or another. It is Jory. Sends over to Gagan up top to Van Komen. Cannon Jensen got stuck there, throws it away. On the run, Roberts. Callan Lewis back down the lane, and Callan will draw the foul. And he will go back to the free throw line. The foul's on J.J. Jory. Number two on J.J. That is the eighth team foul. And the free throw good. So Tyler Mortensen comes on for Coach Lund is emptying the bench and letting Max Toombs get some reps in as he's played with four fouls essentially the entire second half. And Cannon Jensen again on the drive, loses the handle. Try to track down Roberts. He leaves it out for three, and it's good. Tyler Mortensen, and he too a freshman, puts the student section on their keisters after knocking down the three ball. I'm told this is the largest student section Corner Canyon's had this year, the basketball season. Max Toombs, fall away, can't get it. Now on the push, Van Komen. Tate gives that up to Cannon Jensen. That's a tough pocket pass there, gets it back. Corner three, and Jackson Roberts with the roof. And inbound along the baseline as Toombs, Niebauer, and Roberts will come off the floor. And Coach Gardner going some substitutions as well as Josh Davis will come off along with Larson and Cannon Jensen. And what has been an impressive night from Corner Canyon. If you haven't seen the Chargers play yet this year, this is a really, really good team. And we'll be seeing them on Tuesday night as Corner Canyon will be at Lone Peak for, we'll have the doubleheader, Lone Peak boys and girls games. Is that Lone Peak girls team, if you haven't seen them, you have some of the better teams in the West right now. At Corner Canyon, one of the better teams in the West, certainly Intermountain West. And then Lone Peak girls are in the top 10 nationally. So at the line is Tate Van Komen. And the free throw calls off. Kohler trying to track that down. That's off of Corner Canyon. And we'll stay with Skyridge. So Gagan will come off along with Tate Van Komen. And on the floor now is Dane Housley along with Davis Fiennes, Jordan Kohler, Jackson Mosteller, and Jackson Anderson. The student section got their wish for someone. I didn't quite pick up who it was. As Fiennes goes over to Housley, sends to the corner for three, a little long from Jackson Anderson. We'll have a foul on the floor, and that's going to go on Owen Borg. Oh, no kidding. What am I missing? Owen Borg, one of the better linebackers in the state, going to go to play at BYU. Cameraman and the always adequate Austin Bigelow is really excited, as he's known as a BYU super fan. So to the line goes Jackson Mosteller. And the free throw no good. Kohler keeps that one alive. Davis Fiennes couldn't control it. Tracked down by Tag Jensen into the corner. Robertson sends out for three off the mark from Tebbs. Fiennes. And has that one go off the hands of Tag Jensen. Into Anderson. Now Fiennes will float it, and he draws a foul. That's about Davis at the line. Davis, a couple threes tonight. Well, I should say three threes tonight for Davis Fiennes. Hey, sometimes you gotta wear it. And what the moral of the story tonight is, if you're a young student or anybody else, coming to games at your school is fun. You'll be part of the student section. Memories, man. In a movie, Can't Hardly Wait. It's all about the memories. Push it up the floor, three on the way, won't go for Tebbs, and then rebound to Kohler. Here comes Davis Fiennes. Out to Kohler. Kohler on the take, left hand no, and the rebound to Owen Borg. Or Borgie, as he's known around these parts. Three on the way, and good. Wells Robertson knocks down the three. And that will do it. A impressive performance from the number one team in 6A, Corner Canyon. Final score, Corner Canyon 73, Skyridge 50. Your Heidemann and Associates players of the game. First from Corner Canyon, we'll go Brody Kozlowski. I thought Brody was big to get started, really gave all the momentum to Corner Canyon from Jump Street. And for Skyridge, I'd love to go Mason Hunter, but I'm going to go Davis Fiennes. I thought young freshman, he showed something that you can duplicate throughout the year. And something that as Coach Gardner and this team gets through region, they need something out of Davis Fiennes that he can provide to this team. I thought he played really well tonight, the young freshman. But again, our final score, Corner Canyon 73, Skyridge 50 for Austin Bigelow and Kenzie Valentine. I'm Dusty Lister. Thanks for joining us for watching Skyridge Basketball on the Rewind Sports Network on KSL Sports Rewind on KSLSports.com. See you Tuesday night.